Like I said, my name is Josh Rigg. I'm a UX design manager for Wagoneer and Jeep. And it's really nice to be here to talk to you today about one of the leading trends in the auto industry. And so UX is about the vehicle. It's about its technology and how it links to your digital lifestyle, as well as its ease of use and, you know, how it makes you feel. And so when you get into this vehicle, I think one of the things you're going to really notice that regardless of what seat you sit in, front, rear, driver, passenger, you're going to get a sense that this is my space. And I think, you know, I have kids, they get in there and they just relish the amount of room that they have inside of it. So when we layer in the technology part of it in the screens, we just wanted to make sure that we covered these three things. We wanted to make sure that it was purposeful, it's immersive, and that it is personalized, meaning that it's customizable and unique for every individual in the car. So let's jump into the driver's seat. We're gonna kind of take a tour around the inside a little bit and talk about, you know, the main objective here is to make sure that our driver is focused, eyes on the road, and there's not a better way to do that than to utilize a head-up display. And so this is something that's configurable. It's easy to put up a single piece of information or up to five with things like turn by turn and some of the advanced safety features. Right below that, we have a full digital cluster, which is also reconfigurable, and it also can utilize things like full screen navigation and night vision. So if we move just to the right of that, this is kind of more of the heart of the Uconnect 5 system. This is our central display. It has a very familiar UI built on a previous system, but we've layered in a new customizable home screen. So this allows the driver to go in and put all their favorite apps, features, and content within a single touch. You can, we have Alexa integration, so you can ask Alexa to do things like shut your garage door or turn on the lights on the outside of your home while you're awake. For those who like to bring in the digital, like the phone experience in the car, we support wireless CarPlay and Android Auto. In the Grand Wagoneer, just below the central display, we have the lower comfort, your dimension. This is where we bring all of your comfort features right to your fingertips. So you can do front and rear HVAC controls, seat massage controls, as well as some finite seat adjustment here. And then all of these screens, kind of in this general command center area, they all come preloaded with the default setting inside here. But if the customer was to go in and change or edit or adjust any of those settings for themselves, they can save it to one of the five user profiles. And so they can always recall that. You don't have to worry about people messing up your stuff. So next we're going to move over to the passenger side. So this wasn't long ago that this seat was the most coveted seat in the car. I mean, you would fight your family and friends to get up in that front seat. And then soon some of the like technology started to come along, like rear seat entertainment and tablets and stuff like that. It really became kind of like the loneliest place. You were the referee, that passenger seat was just kind of like on call to do things. And so what we really wanted to do was make sure that we could bring that command back to that passenger. And so the front passenger screen allows them to do just that. They have access to view, monitor, and control the content in the rear seat. They can bring in their own media and audio, as well as connect in projector devices through HDMI. So they can pretty much do whatever they want when they want. And then if they need to assist the driver in any sort of way in any activities that the driver cannot do while they're moving, which is things like searching for points of interest, sending nav routes over the driver, they can answer and receive text messages from them, as well as view the vehicle camera. So you can actually get in there and check out cargo cameras. You can look at the 360 camera on the inside, so you can see passengers and check on like the little ones and stuff. Pretty cool. And so if you kind of bring that together with the massage seat function up front here, we've really made this a very desirable seat again inside of the interior. So now we're going to move back to the rear seat. And so one of the great benefits of the connected vehicle is its ability to bridge a gap between what we love and our digital lifestyles. And I'm happy to say we were able to do just that with the integration of Amazon Fire TV into the rear seat. And like I was mentioned, we're the first owner to do so. So we're really proud of that. And so the user can stream any of their TV shows, games, movies, and more. They can do that on two independent streams. So we can do that with one on the left and one on the right, which which alleviates a lot of like fighting and decision-making process, and it's ease of use on parents if they have kids. And then we also allow Alexa in there as well, so you can tell it what you want to watch or play. And then we've integrated some comfort controls inside of there so that it has access to some of those features. We also included a remote that is just like your smart TV remotes. It's very familiar, it's easy to use. And some other apps, like if you're familiar with the Are We There Yet app, we included that one because we know that question gets asked about 100 times in just about every road trip. We have Bluetooth connection for things like headphones and game controllers. And so it's a really great thing. I think the best part about that whole experience is the fact that you can be in your home, you can pause any streaming that you have going on, you can walk out, get in your vehicle, and resume right where you left off. So literally like bringing that living room experience right into the back seat. And if that wasn't enough, I just kind of want to touch on two more immersive experiences. Dwayne kind of mentioned the Macintosh stuff a little bit there. You can't have a true Macintosh audio sound experience without having the icon and the meters available. So there's an app inside the head unit for that. Check that out. And then as well as the second one being something called the Max Mode. It's that cinematic and audio-visual experience that blends across the first three screens in this car. So it's, you know, when you couple that, like you said, we found out that a lot of people sit in their vehicle not driving, whether it's in your driveway, like Sarah said, her husband is doing, you're at the bus stop, you're somewhere else in hiding from work, or you're just taking a break. So that's why this experience exists. And if you couple that with kind of the panoramic views, massage seats, and views like this, it really makes a great immersive experience. So with that, the ability to keep our drivers focused and keep all their main features and functions with a single touch, we've made that front passenger screen and front area of the car more desirable for the passenger. We've got that living room experience in the back seat and these immersive experiences within such things as the relaxed mode. I think we've really delivered our most personalized and most immersive experience today for our customers. So with that, I'm going to introduce Sarah, and she's going to come in and talk about it.